Shaming your significant other. When is it okay to do? Is it ever okay to do? Let's talk about it. G'day there guys, it's your main man Marky and welcome back to another episode of r/AmITheAhole. Now, if you love today's bloody good content, I want you to sit back, relax, chuck a prawn on the barbie, and get ready for some spicy stories. Let's go. Am I the a-hole for telling my husband that he is in fact just like his father? So, my husband and I have four children, a son, a daughter, and twins. My husband and I were over the moon when we had our first two kids, and were just very excited. The twins were a huge surprise, considering twins aren't common in either of our families, but we decided to keep them. However, my husband's attitude towards the twins has completely changed. I know it's tiring. We have other little children running around too, but it's not like we're overwhelmed. My mother, who is still very young and fit, lives with us, and she usually takes care of the kids when she can. We are not short of money either, as both of us come from pretty wealthy families. However, I know that sometimes that isn't even enough when it comes to parenting, so I decided to leave it. However, instead of moping around or just being distant, he's become pretty mean with the twins. He's always finding something to shout at them for. I crap you not, he shouts at them for being identical, as if they purposely planned it. Plus, he's the perfect dad with my older children. He only acts weird with the twins. I had enough yesterday when my youngest asked me why dad hates him, and whether I want him to disappear too. There is absolutely no way a little kid would lie about something like this. I don't think he has the mental ability to make up things like that either. I was furious and confronted my husband, who was sound asleep in the bedroom. I asked him what his effing problem was and why he was being an a-hole. He was confused, so I explained. He then accused my son of lying and saying nonsense. Obviously, I didn't believe him, and I told him that he was exactly like his father. He got pissed and left the house. I don't know where he went, and honestly, I don't give a crap. Side note, husband's father was, in short, a piece of crap. Very absent and cheated on his wife a lot. My husband vowed to never be like him and gets very heated at the mention of his dad. Anyways, my mother, who heard the whole thing go down, told me that I did the right thing by shouting at him, but I shouldn't have mentioned his father. My sister, who I called later, said the same and told me to make a post on here just to see. So am I the a-hole for telling my husband that he's exactly like his dick of a father? Sometimes comparisons like this have to be made so people reevaluate themselves and their actions. I understand this may be a trigger in some ways for him, and you could have triggered something in him, and he just does not like when this man is mentioned. I don't think you overdid it in this situation. I think he needs to probably get some help and just think about his actions and think about his future with you and the kids. You can't allow this disparity of treatment between the two older kids and the twins. That's failing your kids if you'd done nothing. So really, you've done an amazing job for stepping up for these twins and, you know, pushing him to be a better person. And if he's not going to treat them right, if he's going to continue to abuse them, he probably has to leave. That's just how it is. Or some other arrangements need to be made. But I think you've done the right thing here. He has morally failed. He needs to think about what he's done. Not the a-hole OP. Now in the comments, Lahuthian says, "Not the a-hole. He sounds like an asshole. People who are abused often become abusers. This isn't acceptable. Not the a-hole. But I actually think you're failing your kids. You can't allow him to keep treating your twins like that. It's a terrible environment for them to be raised in. Your husband needs to get into therapy and change his attitude, or you need to leave him. Poor little boys. He's scapegoating them while treating the elder two like golden children. It's classic abuser behavior, and OP needs to step up and stop allowing it to happen." Yeah, OP needs to step up and put a stop to this. It's possible that she didn't quite realize how abusive he was being towards them. My mom was abused, and it made it hard for her to recognize abuse towards any of her children. She might have been raised around some forms of abuse. You've got to remember, abuse has only really been shouted about in the past few decades, and there are still pockets where it's kept hush-hush. Not the a-hole, I'm sorry. I encourage you to keep being an advocate for your twins, and if he's saying things like that around them, maybe limit their one-on-one time with their dad. Crap like that is so, so damaging to kids. And they're not too young to understand, as you pointed out. They know they're being treated differently. Whatever you do, don't subject them to someone who is unkind to them constantly. And good luck. Yeah, OP, you're not the a-hole for being upset, but keeping your younger two in a home that is obviously emotionally damaging to them because the marriage is good for you, that's not being a good mother. As a parent, it's your job to put your kids first, and you clearly have both the money and support to do this without living with your husband. At a certain point, you have to realize that you can't just sacrifice the twins' well-being for everyone else in the family status quo. Plus, if left like this, it may create a rift between the twins and the older children in the future. Imagine seeing your father treat your older siblings good and treat you with annoyance. Someday, the twins are going to be old enough to realize not only did their father not love them enough and mistreated them, their mother didn't love them enough for their well-being to be a deal-breaker either. But people are acting like she can just leave and take the kids and never have to see hubby again. Unfortunately, that's not how our court systems work. He's either going to get 50-50 custody or every other weekend, where he'll be able to continue damaging the kids, unfortunately. Our systems are designed to be fair to the parents, not protect the best interests of the kids. So yes, she should leave him to show the kids that that's not the kind of treatment one puts up with or how a healthy relationship should be. But that's unfortunately not an easy fix to this situation. SD Rose 29 says, OP, you need to protect your twins. Your husband may not have said that he hated them or that he should disappear. Your husband is showing that in his actions. By shouting at them, by being mean to them, but then being all loving with the older two, he's showing that he doesn't like them. He's showing that he doesn't want them around. He is being abusive. Maybe being compared to his father will give him the kick in the pants that he needs to realize that he is treating the children different. He needs to go get help. He needs to find a therapist to help him work through what about the twins he is struggling with and how to overcome it and be a father to all of his children. And you need to continue to hold him accountable for his behavior. As for the twins, you need to keep a special eye on them. They are internalizing his treatment of them. They could act out, be extra aggressive, or they could be shunning other people because they're scared that that person won't like them. So they're protecting their hearts. If you are seeing behavior that is different from what you saw with the first two, be their advocate and get them the help they need. Maybe even have them talk to a children's therapist. Your older two might also start treating them meanly too, because if dad is treating them like that, why can't they? Not the a-hole. And OP replies, this is what I'm terrified of. My daughter had started to treat her little brothers the same way her father does, but thankfully I managed to put an end to that pretty quickly. As for the twins, I haven't seen anything concerning, minus what my youngest told me about his father, but I'm definitely looking into therapy or some type of help just in case. After all, there may be something that I'm not seeing. I hope my husband does realize how horribly he's behaving, but I will not let him near any of my kids until he proves to me that he can treat all my kids with equal love and respect. I have been way too easygoing with him and am at fault as well, but I refuse to let my children feel like they're hated or unwanted. I will definitely do my best to protect my babies and, well, thank you. Our next post is by user Rin Spoons. Titled, Am I the A-hole for getting mad at a coworker for refusing to use my name? So I recently started a new job. Now, don't get me wrong, I like my coworkers. Apart from some drama that started previous to me joining, they all seem to be lovely, inclusive people. We work long shifts, 13 hours, on our feet the whole time, so I feel like this could have contributed to my crankiness and perhaps misplaced anger at the situation. For context, I'm non-binary, and although I haven't legally changed my name, it's in the works, I've only gone by Rin. The only people who know my dead name on site are my supervisor and my manager. My name is one that I spent a long time choosing and has meaning to me. So I feel like I'm justified in wanting people to use it. Not necessarily more so than people who go by their birth name, but justified nonetheless. One of my co-workers, S, late 20s male, deliberately mispronounces it. Not with malicious intentions, but because it makes other people laugh. I laughed initially, but when I tried to correct him, he was pronouncing it Ren instead of Rin, he laughed at me and told me that it was no big deal and that his accent makes it hard. However, although English isn't his first language, he doesn't have much of an accent at all and has no problem pronouncing seemingly anything else. His compromise was simply to call me R. Now, R isn't bad. I didn't mind it at first, but coming out at work was a big deal to me, and I feel kind of disrespected every time he calls me that. Usually, I wouldn't consider myself to be the a-hole in this situation, but yesterday he called me R, and it was the last hour of my shift. I was tired and ready to go home, and I said my name is Rin, not R, not Ren, Rin. It's not difficult to say, get over yourself. I'm sick of asking you. If your accent makes it hard, then bloody practice. Now, the reason I'm asking today is that I've been getting weird looks, and the atmosphere is wrong. I feel like I overreacted and thus tainted the way my co-workers see me. I don't want the next 4 months to be awkward since I work here full time. Am I the a-hole? Edit. Some people have pointed out that I initially didn't mind R as a compromise, but S and I would go back and forth each morning between Rin and Ren or R. Although to be fair, it could have come off in a joking manner since I'm not a very confrontational person. I understand you're not a very confrontational person, but you created conflict here and confrontation that I feel like was unnecessary. You gave the green light to him calling you R, and you blew up anyway. If you're going back and forth between Rin, Ren, and R, I understand that. But to me, I'm not getting a sense of you gave him fair warning that you were going to burst out like this at him. This went from 0 to 100 really quick, and while I agree there's some justification for your annoyance here, I think you went too far. You went too far into the red zone. If I was a fly on the wall in this instance and I was watching you, as a coworker, I'd be like, Jesus, what the hell is going on over there? Gonna stay away from that. No, thank you. And because of my gut feeling to this situation, I feel like you're the a-hole for this one. Now in the comments, CorkyPig888 says, you're the a-hole. You implied that R was an acceptable nickname to Rin, then snapped at someone for using it and culture shamed them because obviously practice is the immediate solution for learning how to pronounce a lesser common name in a new language. You should get over your own self. My workplace requires only legal names be used. Be thankful that you have an inclusive workplace. I agree that seeing R is okay and then getting mad about it is an a-hole move, because coworker can't know that it suddenly is not okay anymore. A better way to handle this would be, hey, I understand it's very difficult for you, but it's my name, and I would appreciate it if you could try to get it right. Quote, obviously practice is the immediate solution for learning how to pronounce a less common name in a new language. However, if not continued practice, then what is the solution to learning how to pronounce the name right? Waiting for a miracle? It doesn't seem like the coworker is trying to improve at all, which is also an issue. I agree, but the insinuation and demand that a non-language native speaker learn his new name for his own feelings is in itself selfish. If somebody can't pronounce a name, then they can't pronounce it. My parents have difficulty with some specific sounds in English. 20 years learning the language, 100% fluent, trilingual, some words still don't come out perfectly. Demanding English perfection or perfect pronunciation from an immigrant or non-English speaker is borderline xenophobic. Box246 says, you're the a-hole. As someone who has always had problems with their name mispronounced and misspelled, just get over it. From what you posted, they're not insulting you being non-binary. They're just mispronouncing a name, which happens. I had a manager that I worked under for years. No matter how many times I corrected her or anyone else corrected her, she still got it wrong. I didn't blow up at her because it's not a big deal. Hell, I respond to Freakstick if my boyfriend calls me that, which is often. Stop making mountains out of molehills. And Livid Let Die says, you're the a-hole, because he did stop when you asked and compromised with R. Then you flipped and suddenly decided, without further conversation, that he was disrespecting you. Telling someone to get over themselves and practice your name when they've explained their accent is a problem is just a bad look on you. You don't know what words he does and does not struggle with. Just because he doesn't seem to have a problem to you, doesn't mean he doesn't struggle. If I was any of your co-workers, I'd think you're an asshole to this guy and wouldn't want to engage with you. And back to the post, OP offers an update and says, after my shift ended, I talked to S and apologized for my outburst. Thanks to a lot of people educating me on how, even though S has no accent, some pronunciations can be more difficult, I told him that it was unfair of me to lash out like that, and that I'm young and still an adult and should be more in control of how I react to things. He told me that it was okay and he shouldn't have poked fun, and did end up saying that he had noticed I looked uncomfortable, but since I never said anything, he didn't think that it was too much of a big deal to me. He also said he would make a conscientious effort to pronounce my name correctly, after I explained how it meant a little more than it might to someone who goes by their birth name. Thank you for everyone who responded. I recognize that it was wrong for me to immediately assume that he was trying to be funny, instead of simply his inability to pronounce my name. Turns out that it was a little bit of both. And our next post is by user Eggs Benedict T, titled, Would I be the a-hole for not wanting my roommate's kid at my house? So I, 30 female, have a roommate, 22 male, who has a 3-year-old son. I live in a 1,100 square foot condo in downtown Phoenix, Arizona that I've owned for the past 2 years. I solely own the condo and have put $40,000 to $50,000 into fixing it up and remodeling every surface of it. I also did most of the labor myself as well. Now, for some backstory, I don't have kids and I don't think I want kids because I think it's a great responsibility and don't have the time to truly dedicate to it at the moment. I'm building my career still. If I do decide to have kids, I would put all the effort needed to have a good kid and be a good parent. I'm also not ready to give up my quiet and very clean lifestyle just yet. I would also want a bigger place if I have kids. Now the issue. My roommate's been living at my place now for about 6 months. We are somewhat friends, but mainly just roommates. He's close with my boyfriend though. He moved in after living at my boyfriend's place for about 8 months, so we've all lived together for a little over a year. The roommate is young and doesn't have a great job, so I gave him a discount on rent, at around $600 a month total, just to help him out. I wouldn't have a roommate at this point if he honestly didn't need the help. He may not be fully aware that I'm giving him a deal, but knows my last roommate paid $900 a month plus utilities. The location is prime and it's fully remodeled and updated. He has a son that lives with his mum full-time, about 3 to 4 hours away. He sees his son on occasion, but nothing too consistent due to money reasons, so he claims. He understands that I'm not wanting a kid here often or at all, considering it's a small place and I like my space to be quiet and clean. And to be blunt, if his kid destroyed anything, he couldn't afford to fix it. The past 2 weekends, he's had his kid stay here. Now, before I sound like the a-hole, hear me out. This kid's not just a 3-year-old, but a 3-year-old with negligent parents. He swears, cannot count to zero, has zero structure, doesn't really talk, and gets into things he knows he shouldn't, like grabs all the remotes and moves them out of place. It's obvious the mother doesn't do her job as the parent, and my roommate isn't much better. Please just trust my judgment on this, I don't want to get lost in the weeds here. I do feel bad for the kid, but my days off having a 3-year-old running around my house is not what I thought I was getting into. Edit to add, in the over a year living together, this is the first time we've met his kid or his kid has stayed with us. They always stayed at his aunt's or dad's house for the weekend. Would I be the asshole if I asked my roommate to not bring his son here anymore to stay, or not to make a habit of it at least? If his kid was well behaved, or even if my roommate actually took him out to do something fun besides be inside expected to sit still all day, I think I could grit my teeth and deal with it. But his parenting really drives me up a wall, and if I wanted kids around at home, I would legit just have a kid. Would I be the asshole for requesting my condo as a kid-free place, except on rare occasions? I feel I need to say something now before it becomes a habit. Edit, further information, I've lived with him for 6 months prior to him living here as well. He was originally my boyfriend's roommate. He never brought his kid there or here in the 1 year that he lived with us, always his uncle or dad's house. He's also only gone to see his kid maybe 10 times in a year, which is his choice. We discussed it on the front end before he moved in, and he said that he wouldn't be bringing his son here. Nothing in writing. He didn't mention to me that he was planning to bring his kid over to stay this current weekend. He kinda just surprised us with it. There's been no discussion on his part regarding how often this will occur now. Mind you, we went from his kid never being here the past little over a year to now the past 2 weekends with no real notice. More clarification, when his son is here, my roommate sits in his room most of the weekend. He doesn't take his kid to the park or really try to play or hang out with him. Legit, he just keeps a 3-year-old he never sees locked in his room with him or lets him roam around the house. Edit, my roommate's kid just broke the glass ball on my ceiling fan. He was jumping on my roommate's bed, messing with the chains, and ended up hitting it off place, and the ball fell and broke. My roommate, I assume, was just sitting on his phone in the room while this happened. He was in the room with him. I heard the kid jump around for at least 5 minutes until I heard the glass break from the other room. I think not allowing your roommate's kid to stay with you on occasion, yeah, it might make you the a-hole, but it's your house, your rules. You should go get it in writing that he doesn't bring the kid here unless under extraneous circumstances, or he leaves. That's the best case scenario here. You're already giving him such a good deal, $600 a month as opposed to 900 plus utilities, that he needs to respect that. And obviously he has no respect for you. He needs to learn his actions have consequences in this situation, and he needs to stand up, mature a little bit more, and actually be a parent that isn't negligent. It's sad that these things have to happen and continue to happen in this world, and I would like to see a stop put to it, but like, what can you do? At this point, this problem's just gonna continue if you don't do anything about it. So I'd say not the a-hole for this one, I don't blame you. Now in the comments, Kraluric says, not the a-hole, but the best solution would be to find another roommate. Everything else will not work out. And OP replies, yeah, I'm realizing that now. I genuinely just wanted to help this person and give him affordable rent in this insanely expensive economy. Look, I'm the same as you. However, boundaries and rules clearly need to be set. I see a lot of commenters talking as if you're just a landlord, but this is your living space too, and you paid a lot of money to make it your home. You have to consider your own well-being. And OP replies, thank you, I'm realizing this now. Doohickey replies to that, the thought keeps crossing my mind that the kid would be better served if you also confronted your roommate about why you're making this rule. I'd point out that it wouldn't be happening if he parented his child. 3-year-olds' minds are really active, so that kid is basically being stunted in his development by lack of structure, stimulation, and apparently affection too. You're not the a-hole, but man do I feel for that kid. Not that you should feel obligated in any way to parent him. And OP replies, I totally feel for the kid. I actually think my disappointment in the roommate's poor parenting is a big factor in my emotional thought process about this. I don't have kids, so who am I to give advice on how to be a better parent? I feel that's not my place. Maybe that's why I originally went the extreme route of the kid not being here. I feel super bad for his son. Litho Giraffe says, he didn't bring his kid over to your boyfriend's apartment for a year, but then suddenly he's bringing his kid to yours. I wonder if the roommate thought that having a female roommate, that she would take care of the kid. He doesn't sound like a very diligent father. Has he been trying to use you as the babysitter? And OP replies, yeah, legit, in the 1 year, the last 2 weekends was the first time ever. I finally just met his kid after living together for a year. I added that clarification in the post. Like, he doesn't expect me to babysit, but when his kid gets into crap, I'm the one telling him no, don't do that. You are conflating two issues here and not addressing one of them. You do not want the child around, the child is neglected. To the first point, you're a landlord. Your tenant, whether a friend or not, has a legal right to private enjoyment of the property. Where I am, you can't prevent them from having guests, including their child, as long as the guest isn't staying long term enough to be considered living there or breaking the law in some way. You can't control your tenants' lives. The second issue is that a child is currently being neglected, and that's why you have issues with them. If you're upset because he leaves the child unsupervised alone all day, and the mother isn't parenting well either, call CPS. This is neglect. You can't just leave 3-year-olds to fend for themselves. And OP replies, to address your first question slash point, I live here also. He's renting the other room where I also live. If his kid is now going to be here every other weekend, that's an adjustment for me. I'm okay making the adjustment with boundaries. I just would have preferred that he talked with me about it first. I'm realizing I'm not frustrated from a landlord's perspective. I'm frustrated from a roommate perspective. If I didn't live here also, of course, you do you, but this does affect my living situation having a kid here. My boyfriend and I smoke weed, we do have adult friends over on occasion, I swear, etc. It's just not currently my idea of a kid-friendly household. I'd have to make adjustments to accommodate a kid being here. Second point, he's here. He just doesn't really pay much attention to him. Like, he'll be chilling in his room most of the day while his son is being a bored 3-year-old. He's not leaving the kid unsupervised, he just isn't really trying to do anything with his kid either. Does that make sense? The mum situation, I don't know anything more than what he's told me, and he doesn't like her, so I'm not sure how true or not true those statements have been. Alright guys, that's the end of the video. Friendly reminder that I'm now posting daily on my second channel, Marky2. If you want to laugh at memes with me, link is down in the description below. On phone, you just click that little arrow underneath the video. I also want to say thank you to all my channel members and Patreon subscribers. Your names are currently floating down the screen here, and I love to see all of you guys. Thank you for joining me on this journey. Thank you for supporting me. I really appreciate it. If you see yourself on screen, I want you to give yourself a big pat on the back for being amazing as always, and thank you for supporting me again. I do hope that you guys have a good day, night, sleep, whatever it is you're up to. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.